much indeed. Hello, good evening, and welcome to Wales. This is the 10th Most Haunted Live, and tonight and over the next few nights, we're going to be lifting the lid on Wales's darkest paranormal secrets. I'm David Bull. I'll be your guide in a world of darkness and fear. Now, tonight, we're coming to you totally live from the village of Llanbedr in northwest Wales. In front of our specially invited audience, myself and a team of experts, paranormal investigators, scientists and historians are going to come face to face with the unknown. So why are we here? Well, we've picked this unique venue because it's one of the most unusual and powerful paranormal regions in the country. And our mission is nothing less than the investigation of that paranormality. What is it? Why is it? And who is it? Those are the questions that we hope to answer over the next three nights. And with us on this incredible journey will be our audience. And every night we welcome 300 of our harshest critics, oh yes, the public. Many of them have travelled hundreds of miles to be with us here tonight, and all of them are looking, as we are, for the truth. So hello and good evening to all of you in our audience tonight. It is going to be a roller coaster weekend, it really is. We have so much in store for you. Let's have a little look at what you can look forward to.
Over the next three nights, Most Haunted Live takes our investigation over Maes Artro site, and we'll look into rumours of a ghostly man who wanders in shock through the old mess hall. The mystery of the aquarium that once was a morgue and now is empty, dark, derelict and haunted. The secret of the lost underground chamber. The dark and terrifying woods from which children's crying is heard. The World War II crash relics which have become a psychic hotspot. The unusual mysteries of the weekend's dark moon, and we'll perform a controversial time slip experiment. All coming up over the next three nights on Most Haunted Live.
On the stage with me tonight to help us understand all that we see are our historians, Richard Felix and Richard Jones. Good evening to you. So joining me centre stage, our very own Mulder and Scully. Yes, they're sceptic Louis Sava and also psychic David Wells. Good evening to you. Now I can tell you that your job tonight, gentlemen, your job is to use your unique and very different visions of the world to help us understand what we are seeing and what we're doing. And over on my right is the man called Julian Clegg and his interactive team. Good evening to you guys. The greatest tool in any paranormal investigation is you, the audience at home. You are viewers because you are the eyes and the ears in the paranormal world. Now, we may be here in the physical plane, but you can be here in so many other ways. And Julian and his team are your first point of contact. We'll tell you a little bit more about that later on. But now, let's meet our frontline investigators, the team whose job it is to take to the streets and get face-to-face with the unknown. So, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me enormous pleasure to say, please will you welcome Yvette Fielding, Derek Okora, and Kieran O'Keefe. Entrance there.
Hello! Hello everyone!
They've been fantastic, they're brave, such terrible weather to
I
be
know.
Here.
Thank audience. You all very much for coming, really appreciate
but,
it.
But tell me, why is do you think tonight and the next three nights going to be so good?
Well, for instance, there have been so many paranormal investigations in this particular place, and so many people have come away absolutely terrified. They have seen things, they've felt things, they've caught things on camera, so we couldn't leave it alone. We just had to come and do a live show here.
And you were telling me earlier that there have been a lot of amateur ghost hunters, yes, who've actually been to this site. You've been quite impressed by what they've found.
Yeah, they did something which we're going to attempt on one of the nights later on, which is a new experiment which we've not actually done on Most Haunted Live. And the footage that they shot was very, very impressive and quite scary as well.
Okay, let's turn to the main man, Derek Okora.
Hey,
nice
David.
To see you tonight.
It's great to see you as well.
Tell me how you felt when you first arrived on site today.
I was quite amazed, David, because I felt conditions, psychic conditions, to be totally different than anything we've ever encountered before. So I really can't make it out. because I've not come across it before. And I'm really, really excited, and I can't wait to get
started. As are we all. Now, Kieran, for you, what are you expecting over the next three nights?
Well, because there have been so many groups here that they've all found phenomena, and it's very hard evidence, I'm hoping we get hard evidence of the paranormal this evening.
But what story lies behind this site? What secrets do Clambedda and North Wales hide?
Maes Artro lies between the dark and imposing Rhynog mountain range and the treacherous Irish Sea in the northwest of Wales. The site was originally built in 1941 to house the staff and pilots of the adjacent RAF base, which saw considerable active service during the war. The site consists of over 10 single-storey buildings, which served as living quarters, the officers' mess, a morgue and even a gymnasium. In its heyday, the site housed hundreds of pilots and support staff from all over the free world, joined in their battle against the Nazis. Sadly, the base saw more than its fair share of air accidents, with loss of life becoming a regular, almost daily occurrence. The nearby graveyard reflects the high death toll, with many of the dead being from abroad. Sad deaths far from their homes. The site and area has always been the centre of paranormal activity, with the local standing stones, mountains and nearby islands being particular hotspots for sightings. But since the war, paranormal activity has multiplied. Allegedly, a ghostly man walks between the officers' mess and one of the other buildings, and the shower block has been the focus of unexplained sounds, particularly early in the morning. The World War II Museum, which now finds a home at the site, seems to attract paranormal phenomena. Staff regularly report poltergeist and audio occurrences. They're often too scared to enter some rooms after dark. Maes Artro, which means meandering river in Welsh, is without doubt intensely paranormally active. Over the next three nights, we hope we can discover some of its dark mysteries.
Well, on this 10-acre site alone, we have 30 reported unique paranormal sightings. It is a massive site. So the question is, where on earth would you start an investigation? Where on earth will you start?
Well, most people would actually think that you would put a séance at the end of a vigil, and we've never actually done this on a live show before. We're actually going to start with a séance. The reason being is because in this particular location where we're going to go, so much paranormal activity has occurred here, not just there but throughout the whole site, and we thought we'd just kick it off and see if we could get going. We've also got a psychic artist, Brian Shepherd, who's going to be there to see if he can draw some of the spirits that we may pick up in the séance, and I am absolutely positive that we're going to pick something up. I really am. Well, here we are. We're in the officer's mess and we're ready to start our séance. As I mentioned earlier on, it is quite an unusual start to the show, but we feel it's possibly the best one here because there's been so much paranormal activity, not just in this room, but in throughout all of the buildings. We have also with us Brian Shepherd, who is our psychic artist, who's in the corner. Everything all right, Brian? You okay?
Fine, thank you.
Okay. So when we start, if you feel the need, just you start drawing, okay? Now, we're all set here. Kieran, are you happy with everything?
Yeah, I'm very happy. I've looked around. I'm quite happy with the table, the surroundings. Using four people who've done séances before. What we're doing this evening essentially starts off from Victorian spiritualism. It's quite a traditional way. It's another form of communicating with the dead. It's also quite safe because we've got Derek here. He's going to be able to close it down at the end of the séance.
All right. Okay, we're ready to start then. So if everybody who is not involved in the séance, stand as still as possible. Everybody okay? Okay, take a deep breath. Okay, try and relax as much as we can. Let's get the energy going around this table. Let's get the energy going. Down your left arm, through the person next to you. Get the energy flying around the table. Try and relax as much as we possibly can. Try and get the energy going. Okay, I want you to try and imagine that there's a white light above this table. This is our protection. I'm now going to call out, if there's anybody here in this room. Is there anybody here in this room with us now? Are there any spirits here with us now in this room? If there are, please could you give us a sign? Please could you come forward?
Please try and communicate. Rapping on the table, move the table. Make a move, a sound, anything in this room. Try and use our medium here, Derek. Try and communicate through him. Give us some information. Who you are, why you're still here. Is there anybody here in this room with us now? Please come forward. Come forward to the center of this table. Please use our collective energy. Please try. Come forward. Come forward. Use our energies. Use our energy. I'm shaking like a leaf. It has got so cold in here. It's freezing, the temperature. God, I am shaking. You see the candle then? You right, Derek? Can you hear me? Let him come in. Who are you? Can you see the candle going?
Squadron. Squadron. Leader. Some squadron leader, lady. Squadron leader.
You are the squadron leader.
I am. I am. I'm through. I'm bloody through.
Give us your first name.
Ian. Ian.
Ian. Hello, Ian.
Yes.
What's your surname, Ian? Tell us your surname.
Ian. Ian. Squadron leader. Ian Morin.
Morin.
Morin. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Good.
Why are you still
jolly,
here?
Jolly good. Jolly good.
Why are you still here, Ian?
I told you we're coming here. I'm a nosy soul. I always have been. I always will be.
Why did you die? How did you die? How did you die, Ian? Can you hear me, Ian?
I fell asleep. I'm normal. I'm bloody normal.
You just fell asleep?
Yes. This is our place.
Do you mind us?
We come many times. Come, Alan. Alan. Alan, say hello. He's shy, you know.
Can you ask Alan to do something in the room? Maybe blow the candle out?
He will in the mess. He doesn't want to be here. He wants to be in the mess. That's his place. It's my place. My true place. Come on, party. Come on. Party. Come here. Say hello. The friendly chaps. Friendly folk. Come on. We're happy, you know. We're happy lot.
Who's party?
Alan Pardale. Come on.
What year is it?
1943, what? Yes, May 17th, if you wish to know.
Okay, come forward, Derek, come forward. Derek,
my head hurts.
All right, Derek, come forward. Your head hurts. Yeah, what's happened to your head?
My head hurts.
Okay.
I'm bloating my bloody head.
Come on. Come forward. Derek, come forward. Derek.
Me?
Derek. Thank you, Ian. Ian, leave Derek now, please. Thank you very much. Derek, can you hear my voice? Derek, it's Ivy. Come forward, Derek. Derek.
Come on, Derek, you're all right.
Come on. Can you hear me? Derek?
Ivy, yeah.
Yeah? You there?
Yeah.
Okay. How does the rest of the crew feel? Because I tell you what, I am so cold. You're freezing. Freezing, isn't it? Have you noticed it dropping here, everyone?
Yeah. Straight away.
There's a breeze going. How do you...
The wildest thing is that there's literally no air movement coming through. I was in here earlier on looking to see if there were any breezes. There's nothing going through. And also the temperature actually here hasn't gone down.
But
I can feel your hands. Yeah. And I can feel how cold they are.
Okay. And Brian, everything okay with Brian?
It's certainly very cold, but We're getting something across now. Something's coming.
Who are you picking up? This is amazing.
Just looking for a name.
Look at the face. Derek, are you there? Can you see? Is this something that you were...
Well, so strong from
the
whole area of that room.
Vivi, this is a Chekhov. Thank you, son. It's Chekhov. I can't get it through. Czechoslovakia. A Czech. A foreign man from Czechoslovakia. Czechoslovakia, you getting your name with this?
Yeah, I don't know.
Come on, eh? Czechoslovakia. Come on. He's a pilot.
Yeah.
He's a pilot. Czechoslovakia, son. Ask him, son. Ask him. He came down. He came down. He was flying over.
He's a brave guy. Very brave man.
Very brave man.
And he's in this room with us now.
Trauma.
Yeah.
He's here now.
He came down in a training flight. He was training.
There was an explosion. There was an explosion.
Yeah. Yeah. There was the flames.
The flames.
Yeah.
Are you getting a name, Derek?
He flew. He came down close to. He was one of three that came down.
Hang on, let's see.
At the hill.
Wait, hang on.
At the hill.
Yeah, there was hills. Yeah, there was.
There's a hill. It's a hill.
It's amazing you're both picking up on
this. I'm getting water now as well.
Yes.
Deep water.
Yeah.
It was on fire. Yeah, it's a bad explosion.
Yeah.
Aircraft fuel ignited. Yeah, hills passed. Approaching more fast. Water.
Something to do with water. The 64. Yeah. 64 keeps on coming.
Into the water.
64.
Drowning, flames out, drowning. Black.
There's a connection with the word Towin. They were on the way they left here. They were on the way, going over Towin.
Yeah.
Towin, Wales.
Please come forward. Please, Ian, if you're here, if there's any of your friends that want to come forward and talk to us, please do so. Please try and do something for us. Please try and move this table. I'm so shaky. Please try and move this table for us. If there's anybody here, try and blow out the candle. Try and make a noise in this room. Try and touch any of us here in this room. Try and touch a member of our crew. We won't be scared. How are you doing, Kath?
I can feel that again.
God, sorry. You can feel what?
It's cold.
The cold.
It's like a draft going around.
Around the whole room. Mm-hmm. You all right, Stuart?
Yes, I am fine. I'm just very, very cold at this moment in time.
Yeah.
Like you say, there was a strong draft all around in this room, so I can feel it.
Derek, how are you feeling? Yes.
I'm totally aware that there's not at this moment in time, and I'm asking quietly, with respect to these spirit people, to again step forward, come close to us. They know that we're not here. I feel that there are a group of souls here that are, even though they're spirit people, they're not unhappy people. I get this joyousness about them, the comradeship about them, and they're not at all unhappy that we're here. There's great joyousness, believe it or not, Evie.
Can we ask them to do something for us?
Yes.
Ask them to do something.
For the good spirit souls that are here, we do know collectively, as a team, that you have had, even under stress of wartime conditions, that you had joyousness, happiness, in between having to fly, having to defend. And we're here in friendship with you, and only can encourage you to step forward, please, and give us that evidence, not just of your survival, but that you are here at this moment, in this atmosphere, in this room. Please come forward. It would so, so please everyone that's watching, everyone that wishes and knows that your existence is so. Please, Anyone that wishes to step forward, please do so.
What was that then?
What the bloody hell was that?
That was at the back.
Is that behind you?
Yes.
What the hell was that?
It was a whack, Chris. See where that chair is?
Yeah.
That chair was
and above
pushed
on
back.
The windows.
It was pushed back.
Did you hear that behind you?
Nobody touched this chair, did they?
No.
No.
There was only one.
No. It was pushed back, rocked. That was the noise.
Did everybody hear that?
I heard it, yeah. Yes. We all heard it.
It looked, it sounded as though
small look here.
On the window, banging on the window.
Yeah.
That's what it sounded like.
I thought it was the chair.
Should we check to see if there's anyone
I'll
go and check.
I'll just go and check outside, yeah. And I'll come back in.
Yeah. Brian, you're drawing. Are you picking up on something?
Yeah, I'm picking up. It feels like it's telling me, but I'm picking up on something. Someone's much to say.
God, someone just like a breath of cold air on my hands.
Yeah.
It's like someone's just blown on my hands.
Two little things on my hair like that. Just before, have you got that?
Well, yeah. That noise, and you went like that.
Yeah. I thought John was behind me before.
No.
And he was right back.
And that's when we heard the noise, because you went like that.
Yeah, he thought somebody
touched me. Come forward, please, do something else.
I feel that these characters, these personalities, spirit men, are real characters. They like a little joke. I get this, like, jokiness about them as they're walking around the circle. While they're stroking across the hands, our hair, and it's like as if, you know, they're just happy to come round. And I feel very, very jokey with them.
There's a cold blast of air coming from this side here.
Yeah.
Can you feel it?
Yeah, it's going round the circle.
Yeah. Come forward, come on, do something else, play a big joke on us, please. Lift the table up.
There it goes again. Did you hear that? Yeah.
There's something on the roof.
Yes. Yeah.
There's something there on that roof.
Come on, please come forward.
It's
make that sound again. Please
it's
come
not wind.
No,
wind,
it moves.
Shh,
let's listen.
Come forward, please do that again. Please, if you're here in this room with us now, just do something else.
No, I've got it here.
You've got it?
I've got a name, yeah.
Good.
Oh, no. Please come forward. Okay. Please do that again.
Jeffrey. I've got a name.
Come on.
Jeffrey.
I am so cold.
Okay.
Someone touched you on the head
so
again.
Himself, but Jeffrey. Jeffrey is a name. There's a strong presence now.
Come on, Jeffrey.
Good.
Jeffrey,
presence.
Ian, come forward. Make that noise again. Please, come on. Do something else. Make a big bang. Do something else. Make something move. Please come forward. Jeffrey, Ian, anybody, touch one of the crew here. Touch somebody in the room. Push something off the wall. Do something so we know where you are. So, Derek, what do you actually pick up as soon as we come into the shower block?
Well, I've become very aware. Now, I feel this is residual energy, meaning it's not a spirit person at this moment in time here. But what I heard, and it was very, very clear, was a conversation that was going on. It was between two males. And I just asked Sam, because it wasn't in English, and I said to Sam, what is that, you know, that I'm listening to? And he said, this individual that I'd heard talking to another was talking in Polish.
Right.
It was a Polish man here, strutting up and down, and quite angry indeed, because he was speaking, the voice link I was getting from the residual energy was, you know, throwing out this, like, anger. And I can't make out what the anger was.
How do you know it's Polish, though? Do you know the language? Up on certain words?
No, I heard. I thought, in actual fact, I thought I was hearing Russian. And I had to confirm with Sam. And he said to me, no, this is a Polish man talking to another Polish man.
Right.
And I could hear the one talking, and now and again, the other one replying. But he seemed to be angry with the other Polish man.
Can you find out why he's angry?
Come on, Sam, help me. I feel what actually happened was, from what I'm receiving here, is that these two Polish, the only way I can put it, they were most certainly military, maybe airmen, was that the Polish man with the angered voice was very upset talking about, thank you, Sam, thank you for helping me with this. The conversation, according to Sam, was about another airman that lost his life. And the person who was strutting up and down was saying it didn't have to happen. It shouldn't have happened. He did not need to lose his life the way he did. It wasn't even in combat.
How did he lose his life?
How did he lose his life, Sam? He was out in a training exercise with others, and they were...
What was that?
Did you hear that? That sounded like a footstep.
Yeah. Did you hear that? Did anybody else hear it?
Very strong, wasn't it? Like as if the heel went down.
Like that? Like my heel?
Just like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's probably him.
Nobody moving. There's nobody moving down here.
That's probably him.
And people talking, it was a proper like...
Yeah. That could be his anger, you see, because it's thick and fast. His residual energy is here. Now, maybe he has come in now, but I feel he was angered because a fellow comrade lost his life in a training accident. That's the only way I can put it. It wasn't even in, like, war-torn conditions.
So he was just training?
Yes.
And it's a big, big room, isn't it? Mm-hmm. It is massive.
Can't tell how big it is.
No, you can't. It's absolutely huge.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you know, this is going to sound absolutely silly to you, Evie. Mm. Even strange. But what is actually...
Did you hear that?
Yeah, I did.
Hear what?
At the back of us.
Yeah, like a...
Shh. Yeah.
Is there anybody there? What is that?
Over there.
Back of the room.
Yeah, over here now.
Let's walk over there.
It's coming around.
I can't hear anything now. I heard
it stopped.
Shh, sound. It was like some movement at the back of the room.
Yeah.
Can we see anything on the night vision cameras, John? Is there anything there?
You can see something. It's very faint though.
Do you want to move forward? Should we go towards that area?
Yeah, let's move forward.
Sorry, Derek.
It's all right.
But we all... Who heard that?
I heard it.
Did you hear it, Kieran?
Yeah.
I didn't hear it.
Did anybody else hear it?
Yes, I heard it.
You did,
you know
Carl?
What it was like? It was. It was the chair being just moved. And the energy here. There's a spirit man here. OK? Who? Go on, Sam. Ask him. Ask him. He won't give it to me. Okay. Mac. There's a Mac again. Mac, is that same Mac? Is it the same Mac that was outside? It's not? Okay.
It's a different one.
It's an officer. McLachlan. Is that the surname? He's an officer.
Can you see him?
I can't see him, but I know
there.
His energy's there.
Let's go.
And it's McLachlan.
McLachlan? Is there anybody here? Shall we try a little bit of table tipping?
We can do.
Yeah.
Do you want to try that?
Maybe that would, help? Encourage activity.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kath, Stuart, do you want to come?
Certainly.
Yeah, let's go. Okay, Kieran, do you want to explain what table tipping is and why we're using... Do we do it without chairs, Stuart? And why we're using... why we use the same group of people?
Yeah, basically, table tipping, again, is another form of communication. And essentially what should happen is that once communication is made with the spirits, the table should start moving, and you can use the movement of the table backwards and forwards or rapping sounds on the table to communicate, to get yes-no answers.
Is there anybody here? Are there any spirit people here in this room now? If there is, please try and move this table. Okay, are you on your own? You are on your own.
Did you die in 1942? Did you die in 1943? You did die in 1943. And you died from a training exercise. Could you make this movement? Could you please move the table more, please? Did you die in a training exercise? You did. And you died in 1942. Did you have a wife? You did have a wife. Did you have children? Could you make that move? Could you move the table harder for us, please, God, Ian? Please move the table for us harder.
Please.
Please try harder. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Fingertips on the edge.
Fingertips on the edge. Were you here earlier, Ian? Were you here earlier? You were. Could you just hear my voice? You could.
I'm David Bull and welcome to Clambedda in Northwest Wales. This is Most Haunted Live like no other, because tonight we are in the midst of one of the most violent storms seen in the area for many years. Gale warnings have been issued, roads are flooded, trees have been blown over. And if you were into conspiracies, you might think that someone was trying to tell us something. Anyway, our broadcast tonight comes from this tent. But tonight we've had to make a very difficult executive decision. Because the wind and the rain are battering this tent, we cannot have our audience in here with us. They're watching, but they are watching from the safety of another smaller building on site. The heavens may have opened, but we are undaunted. This is Most Haunted Live, and tonight, in the wind and the rain, we intend to investigate the unknown. So this is Clambedda. It's the World War II living quarters for the nearby RAF base. It has a deep and dark reputation in the area for unexplained phenomena. There is a very heavy, sullen mood over this place, which has unnerved the whole team. But is this place haunted?
We've come into a place that used to be the gymnasium, and they've got this enormous Anson plane here. And we're here, the whole crew is with us, the investigators. And as we come through, Kieran, you've actually got this thermal imaging camera.
Yes.
Now, this is a first. It's never been seen before on British television. And I don't know if anybody can see at home what it actually does, what pictures that you can actually pick up.
Yeah, I've got...
Okay, you can see me waving.
Yeah, I've currently got you in the screen. As we can see, your face is quite warm, but the rest of you is actually very, very cold.
Okay.
So white and red indicates warmth, but blue, yellow, then blue are the cold,
okay,
coldest areas.
So how would this help, Kieran, in a paranormal investigation?
Well, this is basically your most sensitive form of thermometer. It really, really helps in these sort of investigations, because if you're standing in one area and say, oh, I've got a cold spot here, Derek is standing in another area, or even a couple of metres apart, we can point this at both of you and instantly get a readout that there is a difference in temperature between you. We can get the cold spots. This will pick it up instantly.
Okay. So last night, when we were in the séance, we were really feeling this blast of cold air.
Absolutely.
This piece of equipment would have picked up on that.
Would have been
and everybody
perfect.
At home could have seen it as well.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, Derek, we're here in the gymnasium.
Yes.
For me, it's—I don't know what it is. I just feel there's some kind of feeling here. It doesn't feel particularly pleasant. I know for a fact that many staff members do not like to come here on their own. They always come in pairs.
Yes.
Is there anything that's coming to you now?
Well, what becomes apparent to me, even at this moment, Evie, is that I've got this in this atmosphere, this ether, a mixture just coming out virtually from the floors and the walls of different individual people. These are not active spirit people, but just the memory of, you know, in this area, and a lot of them. But I've become very aware of an angered, stated mind of a man, and it's coming out at me very, very strongly. And I'm going to repeat, I'd like to move on a little bit further on, if I could, because as we go down, I feel as if we're going to be drawn. There's something here. Even Sam's helped me with this. Thank you, Sam. He said here, there's a connection with these two men. Oh, he's talking about two now, but there's one individual. I do know he's angry, and he is active here. In actual fact, I'm sorry for speaking so fast, the energy's making me feel this way. And it's like he spends time around here. And, you know, I wouldn't be at all surprised if people don't like staying. It's because of him. Do you hear that?
Shh, shh, shh.
I just heard a bang over on that side.
Yes.
How do you feel, John?
I feel okay, yeah. I don't feel too uncomfortable in there.
You feel okay now?
Yeah, I feel fine.
Okay. Tom, how do you feel?
I think I'm all right. I mean, I'm just concentrating the job in hand and the weather's probably putting me off a bit here, but so far I'm cool with this, yeah.
Okay, all right. If any of the crew actually feel anything while we're here, you know, you must let us know. Sally, are you feeling okay?
No.
No?
Well, I hate the weather. It's horrible being in a storm anyway.
But it's just adding to the atmosphere as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
What about you, Carl?
No, I feel fine at the moment, I have to admit. It's not a particularly very nice place, but...
what was that?
It was a door.
It was a door.
It's just a door.
It's all right.
Okay.
It's okay. We're all a bit jumpy. Just pointed over there, Derek.
Yes, another wrapping seemed to be coming around that tail end of the plane.
Okay. Johansson.
Yeah, Johansson.
Johansson? Is it you here in this room with us? Johansson, if you can hear my voice... Yes.
Yes, yeah.
You can hear my voice, please tap on the plane again, just to let us know you're here. Please give us another tap. Johansson, is it you that's here in the room with us? Please come forward, please give us another tap on the plane. Look at the flag. Yeah. Johansson, are you here in the room with us?
Yes. There you go.
Yeah.
Please come forward, Johansson. Please give us a bigger sign, just so we know that you're here and you're listening to my voice. I have great respect for you. We all do. We don't mean you any harm. We just want to know why you're here. Can you hear my voice? Please tap louder. Can you hear my voice? Stay on the tailplane.
Mm-hmm.
Can you hear my voice, please? Please do something else for us. We're not asking for party tricks or anything. We don't mean you any harm. Please show us something. Can you show us some lights? Just so we know where you are. Any light anomalies, John?
No.
Nothing?
Nothing yet.
Okay.
Last night, we set up a complex experiment in one of the rooms here at Maes Artro, buildings which served as accommodation during the war for the nearby airbase. Now, the experiment was to attempt to detect a mischievous poltergeist who regularly plays havoc with the war artifacts which are kept in the 1940s room. We sent Louis Sava and Kieran O'Keefe to set up the experiment, and they are with Yvette at the room right now. So let's go over to them now. Yvette, just remind us of this experiment. What did you do?
Okay, we're here outside the room, the 1940s room, which of course we padlocked after we set up some of the experiments. So Andy's here, our security person, who is going to actually unlock the padlock, who's a bit wet as well, and the butler is so bad. Come on then, no one has tampered with this, have they?
No, none at all.
Okay. Okay, Kieran, Louis, do you want to go in first?
Yeah, we're going first.
Oh my God.
Water everywhere.
Absolutely everywhere. On the Polaroids as well.
Okay.
The torch has gone out. We left the torch on.
Shall I pick up the Polaroid?
Yeah, we can collect the Polaroids.
Is the MP3, was it still running?
It was still running.
Okay.
We've got a couple here as well.
Okay, so you're taking these Polaroids now?
I'll take them now, yeah.
And then, can you compare them?
We can compare them to the ones that Louis's just taken, and also because they were taken at regular intervals during the night, we can see if any phenomena occurred on the photos.
Okay, and you took... Oh, there's the torch on.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, and there's the torch off.
So there you go.
So these photographs were taken on the hour, every hour?
I believe so, yeah.
There's
the intervals,
John.
That's at the beginning of the evening.
Yeah. And the torch is off there.
Yep.
Okay, and torches off there. So at some point, the torch went off?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. What about the coins? Oh,
Let me just have a look at the coins. I'm just having a look. They seem to have slightly...
Maybe a slight...
Move.
Slight move here.
Yes. OK, can you get a camera in? Can you see this? One of the coins has ever so slightly moved here. Can you see?
The silver one?
This one here. And also this old penny here. Actually, the closer you look, they're actually, you can see all that. They've slightly, this one's slightly moved as well.
What we can do is compare how they are now to at the very beginning of the footage on the DV camcorder and on a VHS tape, and we can see, but as far as I'm concerned, there is a very, very slight movement.
What do you think about the water? Because I don't know. I mean, I've heard that puddles, water is quite prominent with poltergeist activity in particular rooms. Here's the thermal imaging camera. I don't know if you want to try and use that. I mean, should we look for leaks? Is it coming in anywhere?
Maybe we should try and look for leaks.
Well, Louis, can you see any water coming from anywhere? What about on the ceiling?
There's quite a lot of down.
I mean, we
down
came
here
in and it's all through there as well.
Yeah. I mean, is it very, very heavy rain?
Yeah.
So there's a possibility, there's a leak from somewhere. But like Yvette said, water has been associated with some poltergeist activity.
When you come in here, Derek,
yes.
Do you pick up on anything instantly, or is it something you feel that you've got to wait for a little while?
No, since just coming through this doorway, I'm sensing an individual that's been here, and maybe just of recent, within, I don't know, the last half hour, minutes. It's a man's energy, a spirit man's energy, and he was in here, I'd say no further back than half an hour of our time. And, you know, this man, without a doubt, I sense in the atmosphere what he's left in the residual energy, an officer, and, you know, I've just got a mental imagery. Oh, this is absolutely wonderful.
Go on.
Last evening, when Brian was sketching this mail, and you see, I heard Sam saying, this is Geoffrey.
Yes.
So Geoffrey comes here. Go on, can you more, please, Sam? Yeah? Yes? Does he want to be announced? OK, well, ask him to show himself. Ask him to do something in this room while we're all here. Come on. Yes? And it's him that this other spirit man is looking for, the officer. Is that what it is? Thank you. Was he under him? Okay. Okay, try and give me a bit more, Sam, please. We're counting on this. Right? Flight. Left. Flight, Lieutenant. Is it Lieutenant? Yes, thank you. Flight, Lieutenant. Come on, a bit more, please. Was he the one that was sketched? It is. You're confirming it. Yes, he was showing himself to Brian. Okay, thank you. Flight, Lieutenant Geoffrey. Come on, more. Page. Flight. Flight. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? It's okay, don't be worried.
You all right?
Did you hear? Did anybody
I heard this
just...
mate laughing.
Oh, my God!
Spitting laugh.
I heard
he's laughing
that
at
clear
us.
Clear as a bell.
Yes.
It was a wheezy laugh. Tom, tell me you heard that.
I heard that too, yeah.
I heard it. It came from
that direction, didn't it?
Oh, my God!
It was like a laugh.
It was a wheezy laugh. It was a...
Come on. OK. Flight. Come on. And he is. Sam's confirming. He's the man that was sketched... the other evening.
Geoffrey.
Okay? Geoffrey is grounded here. Or he's decided to come here, stay here, and I feel this other person. Yes? Oh, me waist! Whoa! Take it off, please. Take it off.
You're all right.
Oh, my face was burning, heavy. I was... Oh, my whole face, my face, it just seems to be melting on me. Oh, my God. What the heck is that? What is that? Take it off, Sam. Oh.
It's just me.
Okay. Is this the soul? Okay. Oh, his face is terrible. He's burnt. And it's all. And I just feel as if my eyes are down here. Oh. And go on, Sam. He's a brave soul. He's a brave soul. Terribly, terribly burned. Go on. And Johansson? Is Johansson blaming him, the officer? Yes. Okay. That's why he firmly believes. And he sees him, and there's a whole ruckus that takes place between Johansson and Lieutenant Page. And Page gets angry and storms away from him. And that's when he gets angry, Johansson, and beats and knocks things about. It's his anger still in the ether. And he, hey, sorry, what do you feel? What do you feel?
No, okay. Sorry.
That's me, sorry.
Oh, God. Oh, wow. Wow. Is that how he passed, Sam? Is that how he passed in flames? Did he pass in flames? No, he survived the flames. He survived the flames. And he fought on. He fought on. How? He was terribly disfigured. Terribly disfigured, but he fought on.
Is he here in the room? I heard.
See, I feel his energy. He's listening to us. This Lieutenant Page is listening to us, Evie.
Ask him again to do so. You asked him to show himself, yes. And he laughed.
I've got his name now. Flight Lieutenant Geoffrey Page. We're not here to ridicule you. We're only here to get to know you, sir. Please, whatever sign you want to give us, anything you want to do, please you do so. We'd be absolutely thrilled.
David, I don't know if you can hear me. We're going to... We all heard. I know Tom has possibly picked up the sound of a wheezy laugh. I don't know, Tom, do you think you've picked it up on
sound?
Well,
definitely, because all I could hear is what I'm hearing through the headphones, and I definitely heard the sound that you heard, yeah.
Right, I don't know if there's any way in the studio that we can try and rewind that and maybe see if we can find that sound. I'm not sure, but I know I definitely heard a wheezy laugh.
So did I.
As soon as you said that. That, to me, has really unnerved me. That was so clear, David. It was amazing. It really was.
What we're going to do is look back, rewind it, and see if we can play that out again. Incredible stuff, and those names are amazing. I've had a very quick chat to the historians. They've got amazing news for us, but I'll tell you about that in a bit, because I've got even more bizarre news for you, because I'll tell you at home as well, because the wind and the rain have beaten us. Our tent, our studio, is actually starting to collapse around us. So we're having no... there's nothing we can do apart from to evacuate this particular studio.
Now, David and the rest of the crew in the tent have had to move because of the most horrific winds and weather. Now, while they're relocating, we're going to stay here for as long as possible. We feel that's a really good thing to do, because before we went to the break, a lot of things were happening. We actually heard, I know certain other members of the crew heard, especially Tom on sound, heard a wheezy laugh when you actually mentioned the name,
yes,
of Geoffrey. You picked
absolutely
up the fact. And I've just been told we can actually hear that back. So let's listen to the sound now.
Geoffrey. Come on, more. Page. Flight. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? It's okay. Don't be worried.
You all right?
Did you hear
that?
Sam says it. Sam tells me it's another officer.
Oh.
It's another officer. Who is it? He touched the coins.
He touched the coins. Okay.
The other officer.
This other officer touched and went and touched the coins.
I picked up the coins from the experiment because I thought it might be good to do psychometry if
okay.
we have time.
Yeah.
So I've got three of the coins here.
Okay. There are the coins.
Thank you.
And would you be able to pick up those? You all right?
Yes, okay. No, it's all right. Okay, keep giving me that, please. Keep giving me that. Okay, I'm seeing a mental picture of the man. Bless you. Okay. What? This man, why did they take me over there? Okay, I've just been whizzed over. I'm in France. I'm in lying in a bed. Come on, more. Precious. James. Kick me more, please. I'm badly injured.
Where?
I'm in hospital.
Yeah.
I'm in bed.
Where are you hurt?
Across here.
Your chest?
And here. And my leg.
How were you hurt?
They shot me down. I was shot down. I come back. Who is it? Squadron leader.
James. How old are you?
I had to come home. I had to come back.
Did you die in hospital, James?
Yes.
You did?
Yes.
Why do you still come here? Why are you here?
I flew from here. I sought it from here.
What plane did you fly? Can you remember?
Oh, yes. A Mustang.
What happened? You were shot down in the plane?
I was.
You okay, Derek? Derek?
The nurses.
Derek?
Yeah.
Derek? Is it me? Derek?
James McLaughlin, my dear. James McLaughlin. Macca to you.
Macca. Can you see me?
I can.
You can. Can you see me from above, or can you see me where are you using Derek's eyes?
I am. He's a good soul.
Do you want to what?
I will not hit him.
You won't hurt him?
No.
Okay.
Do you want to see my arm?
Yes. See your arm?
It's a bloody mess. Can you see it?
Yeah, I can't see it.
What do you make of it?
It's very bad. It's
yes.
Awful. And were you shot there?
Bloody metal.
Metal?
Yeah. Look at it.
Mm.
Even the bloody fingers. Marvellous job.
Do you know, James, that you're dead? James? James?
Yes.
Do you know you're dead?
I assume so, dear.
Okay, thank you very much. Let me just explain the situation so that you at home know what's going on. We've had to evacuate our studio because the studio has started to slide down the hill. So we have actually moved up the hill onto firmer ground. As you can see, we're now in the officers' mess. We've joined the audience. Hooray. Good. Very good to see all of you. Now, also, I have to tell you, so much has happened tonight. But let's pick up on some of these facts that they came up with. Derek came up with this name, Jeffrey, this burnt face. I just wanted to ask, first of all, to Richard Jones. Does this make sense to you?
Very much so, yes. There was a Jeffrey who fits the bill. He was on a rhubarb mission, and he came back. He did two rhubarb missions, flew Mustangs. So both rhubarb missions were in Mustangs. He said Spitfires and Mustangs as well, and rhubarbs were always flown in Spitfires and Mustangs.
Right.
And the interesting thing was that the mission that he came back from, the second one, was the one that Mac didn't come back from. Remember, we talked about Mac yesterday.
Yeah, Mac. We discovered Mac last night,
yeah.
Didn't we?
And Jeffrey had a very scarred face. He'd come here to recover. He'd been treated at the Queen Victoria Hospital in East Grinstead, and he'd had pioneering plastic surgery, and he'd come here to recover. Mac was the one, if you recall, who had the artificial iron or steel arm with the...
Yes, I do.
I believe, didn't he say at the very end there that he
did. Well, and what about this, another officer? He touched the coins. Do you remember? He said he touched the coins, and then Derek picked them up and went, I'm in France, lying in bed, fingers spitfire, and then said James and this name Mac. Does this make sense?
Yeah. Mac was shot down over France. He wasn't actually killed in the air crash. He was shot down, and he died 3 weeks later in a French hospital.
So Derek is absolutely correct with these names?
Very much so, yes.
Impressed?
It still is public domain, but it is
impressive. Well, let's ask your colleague, Richard Felix, what do you make of it?
I'm very impressed. The strange thing is, though, that this Geoffrey Page didn't die till 1980. He was very badly scarred, burnt, but he died, well, say, only 4 years ago.
Right.
I can't understand really why he would come back here and haunt this. But the thing is, of course, you must remember that with the terrible trauma of these terrible, terrible burns, we've got things called crisis apparitions. And in fact, 40% of all ghostly sightings are actually made by people that are still alive. And I'm wondering whether it's more residual energy that's here from this chap with this dreadful trauma that happened to him. But I'm not sure.
I have to say, it is an incredible night. Two names right there, James and Geoffrey. But what else could possibly happen tonight?
We're here in the morgue. It is the most awful place, one of the most awful places I've ever been to. It's got a horrible, horrible atmosphere. And as soon as we came in, we've been standing here for a while now, Derek, and you actually said to me, this is not nice at all.
Yes. And the feelings that are in the atmosphere here is just great, great, great sadness. And, you know, before the build-up in the ether of the sadness, all the agonies and the feelings that go with it, and it's not nice. And just, you know, by the energy going in that direction, I feel it will worsen.
Okay. Well, if you guys just stay here for a minute, because I want to go down further into the morgue, because at the very end, we've actually got Brian Shepherd, who's our psychic artist. And poor Brian is right down here. You're going to stay close, because there are bats in here as well. And if anything comes anywhere near me, I am going to screen the place to bits. As you can see, it just goes on and on and on. Oh, my God. Brian?
Yes.
Are you okay?
Hi. Oh. Yes, I am.
Have you started drawing?
I've started to draw, yeah. I'm picking up quite a group in here. There's quite a lot of energy. Yeah.
Tell me what you're feeling.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I'm feeling a presence of... getting a very strong feeling in this area here. High. This is a person. 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 Oh, it's coming again, Jeff.
Jeffrey?
Jeffrey. Is that you? Sorry, the voice is off. Jeffrey. Yeah, no, it's
okay.
Yeah. Jeffrey. I'm more grounded. There's a group of people.
Okay.
Sorry, group. Yeah, there's a group of people around here. Sorry, cold. Cold, clinically cold. Hospital. Geoffrey again. Yeah.
Is he here now?
Yeah, he's here. He's here now.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. And heat. And heat.
Heat?
Yeah, heat on my hands. Heat. And burning.
You okay?
I'm burning on my hands. Okay.
Do you want me to help?
No, yes, sir. Yeah, I'm okay. I'm okay.
Do you feel
okay? Yeah, there's a lot of pain here. This is definitely Geoffrey. Yeah, very man. He He was badly burned, with on the face and hands.
Tell me what you're seeing. What you're seeing.
I can see him, yeah. Yeah, he's trying to...
What's he trying to do?
He's come out into the light. No, side of his face and body are in the dark. No, he's overseeing. He's looking down upon us. Okay. No, he didn't. No, I'm sure he didn't die in here.
Are you all right, Derek?
There are.
Yeah?
Yes. He didn't die in here, no? Now, there is death in here.
There's what?
There's
death.
A sense of death in here.
Yeah.
Yeah, and trauma.
You all right, Derek?
It's not nice. And darkness.
It's so cold.
It is cold, yeah.
It's really dropped in this temperature.
Yeah.
Can anybody else feel how cold it is?
Foreign. Free. Yeah, foreign. That's...
Basically, what you're looking at, we're not going to do table tipping. This is not the ideal table for table tipping anyway. The focus is on the glass and making the glass move. It's the same sort of principle as table tipping, in that we'll have collective energy, we'll be trying to communicate with the spirits and get the glass to move. Also, it could be group psychokinesis. That means we could be using group psychic energies to attempt to move the glass.
Okay, so the spirits could be in this room. This is why we've set up this particular experiment, to try and encourage any paranormal activity. Maybe it's a good idea. Actually,
yes,
if we put our
yes.
place off fingers
yeah.
on
the
let me move this so that okay. put that on the floor.
Okay.
Okay.
So if we just put our fingers very, very lightly on the glass
yeah.
and just touching there. Are you happy with everything, Kieran?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Is there anybody here in this room with us now? Are there any spirit people here in the room with us now? If there is, please could you give us a sign? Please, could you do something in this room to let us know you're here? Try and talk to us. Please, let us know if you're here. Please, could you try and move the glass? The glass is moving. Mm-hmm. Can you
slightly,
feel it?
Yes.
It's vibrating.
Yeah.
Yes.
No one's pushing this glass, are they?
No.
If you wish to talk to us, please, can you move the glass? Please, move the glass. Please, try harder. Please move the glass for us. Please move the glass. Please move the glass. Thank you very much. Please move the glass. Derek, can you ask some questions?
Okay. We're very happy for your presence, spirit friend. Please continue to do what you've just started. Give us the impressions, thank you.
Look at that, look
the impressions
at that, look
that
at
you
that,
are
look
strong
at that.
Here. Yes. Okay. I take it that you're happy that we're here. We're not here in any other way to respect you. Can you give us other obvious signs? Can you give us other obvious signs? Apart from the glass movement, knock on the table, around the area of the room.
What?
What was that?
I heard a knocking.
Well, you thought you heard a knocking?
Yeah.
Which direction?
Direction.
Audience,
like on metal.
Do you want to turn around and just tell us what you heard?
Heard a knocking on metal coming from over there.
Okay.
Sounds like sort of metal.
Okay, so that could be
responding. Could you try another knocking sound? Ask him, please.
Yes. Can you try another sound, please? Or anything that you wish to do would be very, very appreciative. Can you come round the circle? And we'd be quite happy for you to touch one of all of us that are sitting in the circle, around the hairline, the face, the hands, the shoulders. Please attempt to do that.
Oh.
He's wanting to come to a vet.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's so cold. It is so cold. Okay. I've just had a blast right across my legs and across my face.
Okay, he's chosen you then. Okay.
I can feel that.
Can you give a little bit more of the indication of your presence around a vet?
Jesus.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Please go gentle.
He's all right across my legs.
Is he? He's
yeah,
okay.
I can feel it. I can feel
it.
He's
become very
table.
Cold, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, he is attempting to do it, but he's a lovely spirit. He's a good spirit man.
I can smell smoke.
Yes?
Can you smell smoke?
I can't smell anything. I'm just so... I'm freezing.
Okay. Okay.
The temperature has gone down by
yes.
About 2 degrees.
His atmosphere is round about now. Okay. You have bingo with you. You have bingo. And I said, we have bingo. He said, yes, you have bingo brown here. So this person is calling himself Bingo Brown.
Okay.
Bingo Brown. And he's looking round this area. It's like as if he's been in and around the whole of this site.
Can you go to somebody else to let them feel
it? Can you move, please? Now that I know his name. Can you move, please, Bingo? How, you don't mind me calling you Bingo? Away from a vet's aura
field.
Did
you feel that?
Yes.
Whoa.
I felt it across here
flipping
as well.
Egg.
Yes.
Where did you feel it?
Right, right across here.
Yeah. Can you choose, please, another within this circle to come close to our auric fields? And then we will know that you are close by us, individually.
Ask him to move the glass who he would like to
go
to next.
Bingo, can you move the glass, please, to maybe the person you would like now to move to?
No.
Oh, sorry. Thank you, Bingo. Please, in a nice, gentle approach.
I can feel it coming across the
I'm
table.
Down, yeah, I can feel it on my legs.
Yes. Just give the indication that you are close to Sally, please, without any harm. I know you wouldn't harm her. You're a gentleman. He's a very authoritative man, but I feel a good man, a good soul, a good spirit man, this.
Are you feeling anything?
I can just feel cold right up my legs.
Oh.
Oh, God, I can feel it.
Oh, God.
He's chosen the ladies.
Can you feel anything, Kath?
Yeah.
Whoa!
That's
sorry.
All right. Okay.
It's just me.
Sorry.
It's just me.
Here.
It's all right.
My hands are icy cold.
Can you feel
whoa.
How cold it's going?
Yeah.
Can
you feel
I'm
it
just
across
gonna
you?
Touch, I'm just going to touch
yes.
Tyson's hands.
Mine's warm, that's okay, but it's getting cooled.
Yeah, but certainly Sally, Kath, and Yvette have very cold
my
hands.
It's freezing now.
Very cold hands.
Yes. I'm all right now.
I feel heat coming from yours.
You're all right.
So, yeah, I'm fine.
He's with me.
Yes.
Can he touch me?
Can you please, Bingo, help? You don't mind me calling you that. Bingo, can you please... oh, God, I just heard him say something.
What? What?
He said, don't you call me Bingo. What's that? It's foreign. It's not English. Don't you go... Go on, Sam, say that again. What did he say? I missed it. Go on. I've got to call him Air what? Air Vice what?
Good.
Air Vice Marshal. Air Vice Marshal. I've got to call... He's here in this room.
Oh. Okay.
Can you... Are you going back to Sally?
No. Nose is
where are you going? Can you do something else, please? Air Vice Marshal. Look at this. Oh, wow. Thank you. Thank you. Bless.
Oh, my God. Oh. Well, I'm completely freaked out by what's just happened here. The glass was spinning round and round. How did everybody else feel? How did you feel, Sally?
I've just gone really cold and my hands are shaking.
Yeah. What about you, Kath?
It's horrible.
I thought it was great. Really, really exciting.
Yeah. What about you, Derek?
I think that spirit man, Bingo, done us proud.
OK.
He tried very hard.
Do you want to very quickly close it down?
Yes, please.
Just very quickly.
Yes.
OK, come on. We have to do it really quickly.
Yes. My good spirit friend, Bingo, we thank you for your efforts, and we would now like to leave you and for you to leave us, and we will go on further into the investigation. And we wish you well. Thank you for your
thank
efforts.
Thank you. I just want to ask our audience member as well very quickly, what did you think to what had happened there?
It was the way it was spinning around. It was like playing. and kind of freaky. kind of weird to ever see something like that.
Right. Okay, Kieran, very quickly.
Temperature differences that people were getting was objectively picked up by my meter. There are possibility of a couple of drafts, but we all saw the glass move.
Okay, and Carl, can you still hear me? Because, Carl, you're in the air raid shelter.
Yes, I can hear you.
Are you all right?
Absolutely fantastic. It's been one hell of an experience down here. I know I'm not on my own. I can't explain why I think that, but I feel very comfortable. I've heard so many things. I've seen a lot of... I've seen a lot of light anomalies, and I'm still hearing things now, which is quite surprising.
What sort of things are you hearing?
I'm hearing creaking, like somebody sitting in a leather chair, or certainly footsteps. I sat down earlier, and I felt two people were kind of next to me, like I was sitting on a bus. But it's very comfortable. It's phenomenal, really. I'm invigorated. I'm not frightened, which.
Which is great.
Yeah, which is great.
Unlike us here.
How's it going that end?
Oh, God, the glass was spinning round. It's unbelievable. So there you go, David. I don't know what you and the rest of the team in the studio think to what's just happened here. I mean, I'm speechless. I'm still shaking. I really can't believe it.
And I have to say, I have never, ever, ever seen anything quite like that. Historians, what about this name, Bingo Brown, Air Vice Marshal?
Well, it's fascinating, actually, because, as we mentioned earlier, Air Vice Marshal Bingo Brown, he was the South African Air Vice Marshal who sent 26 of his 29 squadrons here to train for Operation Overlord, which was to begin with D-Day. So,
and Derek said he was foreign. Was he foreign?
He was South African, and his nickname was Bingo Brown.
Louis Sava.
Well, it's very impressive.
Talk your way out of that one.
Well, I mean, as I said, it's very impressive. Parapsychologists have been looking at this kind of thing for over 100 years now, and you know, there's some very good evidence which shows that unconscious muscular movements, and I'm not saying people are actually pushing it on purpose, but unconsciously are pushing very, very minute forces, muscular movements, which is translated into quite large movements, and there is some very, very good research.
Louis, have you just seen what I saw?
I know it's not impressing you. I know. Well. There is good research, so...
But are you seriously telling me that you honestly, honestly, honestly believe those people moved it round on their own?
I'm not saying that they're pushing it on purpose, okay? I'm saying what they're doing is they're unconscious movements, so unconsciously. Okay. And I'm not also saying that the information they're getting isn't coming perhaps paranormally. I'm not saying that's not possible. What I'm saying is that unconscious movements are causing the glass to move.
David Wells.
Well... I think that it's not just the movement of the glass. Have you noticed that Kieran was saying lift your finger? He was telling people independently to lift their finger, so it wasn't one particular person, because someone could say, like, one of them's doing this.
Yes, and Derek took his fingers off, didn't he?
Everybody did. Everybody in sequence and random took their fingers off. What I think was really interesting was, if you watch these guys, if you watch Yvette, Sally, and even Carl, what these guys have been doing for 3 years, are this twice, three times a week sometimes, their awareness is heightening, so they're all becoming channels. Yvette's emotions. Emotions are a clear sign that spirit's there because you feel the tenderness. That they're all doing it. That's what's interesting for me.
And what do you make of what Louis is saying?
The unconscious movement. I think that maybe we do move it. I'll give him that. But I think it's spirit channels through our bodies. It's the same principle as dowsing, the same perhaps as any kind of healing where it comes through. However, it's subconscious, but because it comes from spirit, and spirit's making a move.
It's rapidly approaching the time to test the success of our time slip experiment. Now, as well as listening to the experiences, as we have done, of those participants, what we want to do is we intend to see what kind of psychic presence has been created by performing a table tipping experiment. Now that's apparently when a group of people harness the psychic energy in a room and then they use it to try to move a table. And we've chosen this experiment at this room because it's already been host to a number of successful table tips. And we can see that in this video, which was made by an established ghost group. So let's have a look at that now. As you can see, these people are around that table. Look, that table is moving anti-clockwise, okay? And they're moving with the table. And they're focusing their psychic energy, making that table move. And as you see, the table collapses.
Is there anybody here in this room with us now?
Is there any spirit person here now in this room that would like to talk to us? We've been here all day.
There's a bang at the back?
Yes.
I thought it actually came from that direction.
Okay.
So.
Please, can you give us a sign if there's a spirit person here in the room with us? If you'd like to talk to us, try and communicate with us so we can get to know you a little better, please try and move this table as a sign of yes. If you'd like to talk to us, please move this table. Please try and use our collective energy. We're here. We don't mean you any harm. Use our collective energy and try and move this table, please. Please come forward. Come into the light and try and talk to us. We know you're here. We can feel you. Please try and push this table as a sign of yes.
That's through there. I'm going to go through there.
Okay.
See you there.
Please move this table as a sign of yes. Whoa. Whoa. Did you feel that?
Yes.
Yeah, came towards you.
Okay. Are you a married man?
He was. Yeah. Oh, 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 oh.
Oh.
You seem to be happy with that.
Okay. Did you have children?
Okay, yes.
Did you have two children? Did you have one child? Did you have three children?
Four.
Three.
Yeah.
Is your wife with you now in spirit?
Yes. Ooh. He's happy she is.
Ooh.
Whoa. Whoa, hey. Thank you.
That was fair.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm fine, I'm fine.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Look at this.
Okay. I don't know, David, what you're making of this. I really have no idea what you guys are thinking in the studio, but we're not pushing this.
No.
We're not pushing it. Take your hands off, Sally. As soon as you take your hands off,
the energy is
the energy
broken.
Stops. As soon as you put it back on, it moves.
Yes.
Okay.
Super.
The thing is, when you push something, you usually can feel if someone's if you were pushing it towards me, I could feel.
I could, yeah, exactly.
Yes.
If Derek was pushing it, I could feel that.
That's right. The
energy seems to be coming right from the centre.
And when you push, the tablecloth goes anywhere.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. Are you still here with us in the room? Have you left, or are you still here? You're still here.
Look.
Okay.
It has been an extraordinary night. I don't think anyone could have expected quite what happened tonight, but it gives me enormous pleasure to say, ladies and gentlemen, please will you welcome them back. It's Yvette Fielding, Derek Acorin, Kieran O'Keefe. Well, I have to say, it's been an unbelievable night. How's it been for you, Yvette?
I'm speechless. I'm absolutely speechless. Yeah. You couldn't have wished for anything better. I'm absolutely ecstatic. We've had a glass going round and round and round, and the table, it hit me in the hip. It was unbelievable, yeah, wasn't it? I'm sorry. I'm so excited.
Yeah. Derek?
Just exceptionally excellent. Thank you, spirit people. they responded to everything our asking. Even more, it went over the top. It was fantastic,
wasn't it?
Great.
Yeah.
Do you know, one thing that I do want to pick up on tonight, you know, you came up with so many names tonight, Hyde, Page, Hurst, McPherson, and this chap, Bingo Brown, okay? Bingo Brown, this was the chap who moved the glass.
Yes.
Yeah, you remember? Do you know, what the historians were telling me just a while ago was that Bingo Brown, all those men worked under Bingo Brown, so they were all accurate men.
No. That's brilliant.
And also, in terms of the officer's mess and that table tilting, of course, that was McPherson again.
Yes.
So we again saw the same person coming back. How does that make you feel, Yvette?
I can't believe it. We've done so many different haunted locations. We've been around the country, we've gone to Europe, and I have to say, I can't believe how it was just unbelievable what happened.
Yes.
The movement, people feeling things, the cold breezes, it was like a whirlwind around me and Kath, around the table. I've never felt things like that before.
Let me ask you, Kieran, though, about all of these things, the table tilting, the glass, everything. What did you make of that? Take that for me and speak through that. But what did you make of those two particular experiments?
Of the movement of those objects? Well, I think I've commented before on this sort of thing. Parapsychologists are aware aware of normal explanations for these particular things occurring. The great thing about the table turning, though, was the way we set up with the tablecloth so that you could see instantly if anybody was pushing it. And that's why it'd be great to look back at the footage and see if that happened. And I was examining it very closely, and for me, I don't think that occurred. Well, I think it was quite impressive.
Where we were sitting, I was talking to David earlier on, as far as we're aware, that wasn't the case, David, is that true?
Absolutely not. It was one of the first things that we picked. In fact, Sally was the first one to pick up on it, that the cloth was, you know, wasn't rushing up. And, yeah, it looked great. It was fantastic.
Now, Louis, interestingly, Derek, says that the table moving and, indeed, the glass moving is involuntary muscular movements. This is what he said. He said, you did it.
I did it.
Well, no, all of you did it.
Oh, right.
No, he's not saying that.
Okay, no. Well, yes, he's open to his opinion. I was there with Yvette, Kieran and everyone else, and we know for a fact, okay, we're checking on each other whilst we've got our hands on that table, and no one but other than a spirit person who was in attendance was moving that table responsibly.
What about when all four of us actually had one finger?
That was incredibly impressive.
On the table. Yes, what do you continued think that,
on. Well, it certainly is very impressive, and I'd like to definitely go back and have a look at that videotape and analyse it.
I think what he's saying also, he's saying it's involuntary as well. He's saying that's what he's saying. So he's saying it's not any sort of conscious movement, and I think we're all very clear that that didn't happen. But as far back as 1852, Faraday was looking into these sort of things. Parapsychologists are still studying it even now, and it's still an open book.
What I can tell you tonight, I was on the edge of my chair watching that class. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. I know our audience here were absolutely gripped. They were so quiet throughout the whole of that, the glass moving and the table. Let me ask you, audience, are you impressed by what you've seen? Yes or no? You see, I think it was a very, very compelling argument, Kieran. It seemed incredibly compelling.
Yeah, well, I think it was compelling. For me, the most impressive stuff that happened this weekend was actually the footsteps. I know we're focusing on the table turning and the actual glass, but for me, as an objective parapsychologist, part of the team has always been the objective one and trying to create balance, it's the footsteps. It's those recording of by equipment, so it's not any sort of subjective experience by somebody. We've got an objective measure on these equipment, and that was fantastic.
So a good result, that.
Very, very good result.
And what about you, Derek? I want to ask you, one thing that keeps coming up throughout the three nights is that a lot of the spirits here, unlike some of the other locations we've been to, the spirits here seem quite jovial, quite jocular, quite friendly.
I've been thrilled, David, how they've been. We've not encountered one spirit that has not been, you know, so loving. This place is full of history, of love, of enjoyment, and also take into account under wartime conditions. To me, this is the pinnacle, absolute pinnacle of our investigation to date. Yeah. They really responded beyond anything I could ever imagine.
And the wonderful thing is that every day has been different. Today, I have to say, wasn't expecting it at all, but what I do want to show you now is what happened tonight. Let's have a look at tonight's highlights.
Yeah, that sounded like a footstep.
Yeah. Did you hear that? Did anybody else hear it?
It's wrong. Whoever the
you're going to do it anymore. I'm going to have to leave.
I can hear you. They can hear you.
It is so cold.
Flight. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? It's okay. Don't be worried.
You're all right.
Oh, my face. Take it off.
And would you be able to pick up that? You all right?
Yes. Okay.
And burning.
The German prisoners of war here. In groups.
Right.
From a bench.
Did you feel that?
Yes.
Is it MacPherson?
Oh. MacPherson, thank you. Please stop spinning the table.
And I have to jump in and say to you, Yvette, final comments to you. How have you felt about tonight's and indeed the whole 3 days investigation?
makes you want to go on, do more. We will not stop until I actually see a ghost standing right there in front of me. I've got to keep going on. And of course, we've got the brand new series of Most Haunted. It's 9 o'clock, starts tomorrow. You've got to watch it. Absolutely fantastic.
Well, thank you very much to all of you guys. Thank you to all of our team. Thank you to Julian and Interactive. Thank you to our historians, Richard Jones and Richard Felix. Our experts, Louis Saver, David Wells, and of course, Brian Shepherd. Our team, Kieran O'Keefe, Derek Acora, and Yvette Fielding. And all of you here, our audience tonight, and indeed over the three nights, because all of you have been brilliant. Last night's audience, fabulous to brave the elements. All of you have been really, really amazing. And now we do have to take our leave from you. I can tell you, though, we will be returning for another Most Haunted Live over Halloween, where you can forget all the trick-or-treat cliches and you can investigate on what All Souls Eve really means. It has been an amazing 3 days. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. I know all of us have. And that is it from the world's largest psychic hunt here in Llanbedr in Northwest Wales. From all of us here, good night.